Hello and welcome to another Overlord lore video. And while in my last video I gave you an overview about world items in general and dove into the background and lore of the most well-known ones, this video will be dedicated to the smaller, niche and entirely unknown and rumored world items. So let's start with another two from the Vault of Nazarick. And here we will begin with Hygieias Bowl. This item was handed to either Demiurge or Cocytus in order to protect them from other world items after the Shalltear incident. And while nothing concrete about this world item and its effect is currently known, it likely has healing powers. Hygieia was the daughter of the Greek god Asclepios, and the bowl is one of the most well-known and important symbols of pharmacy, health and healing in general. So if Cocytus, one of the most powerful beings in the entirety of Nazarick in terms of raw armed attack strength, has such a mighty healing item, he could fully commit himself to offensive actions, which would make him even more dangerous. And if Demiurge has received this item, I suppose he can better utilize his happy farm. And with that said, let's continue with Billion Blades. Similar to Hygieias Bowl, it was given to either Demiurge or Cocytus for the same reason. And the name suggests it is an incredible offensive weapon, which would make Cocytus an even greater threat, or it would enable Demiurge, a commander rather than a warrior, to defend himself when confronted with a stronger opponent who specializes in close quarter combat. And of course it is also used for protection from other world class items. Furthermore, in the fight against Shalltear, Ions summoned magic obsidian blades. And since world items are oftentimes normal spells, but with tenfold the potency, Billion Blades could very well summon exactly 1 billion obsidian blades, swirling around and slashing your enemies into subatomic particles. And while back in Yggdrasil the computing power was a somewhat limiting factor, the now made real world items aren't bound anymore by such restrictions. And therefore I really hope that we will see this one in action at some point in time. And with that said, let's take a look at an old friend, the Caloric Stone. A one-time use world item that still isn't part of the 20, it was suggested that the Guild of Einzulgaun used it to create an extremely strong golem, since this world-class item can also function as a golem's core. And I personally believe that it was used to create Rubedo, Albedo's younger sister. Since it was stated that she wasn't created by normal means, and since it was stated that she also needed to be activated or powered up, and I already made an entire video dedicated to precisely this theory. Link is, as always, in the description. And now we will take a look at the Throne of Kings, one of the more obscure world items, despite being present in most scenes with Einzulgaun in Nazarick. And it was awarded to the guild for clearing the dungeon of Nazarick, the later guild base, in one attempt. And this WCI is likely based on the Throne of Gods, an item that never made it in its intended form to Dungeons and Dragons. Likely because the effects intended were game balance breaking, which in turn would make it an excellent world item, which are supposed to be overpowered. And the Throne of Gods in turn is likely based on the black marble share of Zeus, so we can see a clear parallel between the first of the Greek gods and Einzulgaun, who is the leader of the supreme beings. But aside from the origin of the item, we pretty much have only the name to talk about possible effects. So maybe this share buffs the character stats, especially intelligence or other important parameters for ruling. Maybe it has some guild related effects, like lowering upkeep cost, increasing the effectiveness of those subservient to Ainz, raising the combined level cap of Nazarick. And maybe in the new world this throne aids Ainz unconsciously, enabling him to do the best thing for Nazarick, despite having no experience as a ruler. Or maybe it is just a metaphor for Shalltear, you never know. And with that, let's continue with Atlas, a world item which once belonged to Nine's own goal, the precursor organization of the guild Einzulgaun. But at some point it was stolen by unknown enemies back in Yggdrasil. And while its abilities are unknown at this time, we can assume that it has something to do with the world itself, since in Greek mythology Atlas was the titan that upheld the entire world, and it was said that he upheld the world in the extreme west, which might be an indication for where the item currently is located or has respawned. And my personal theory is that Atlas is a world shaper, an item that can be used to actively trans and terraform parts of the nine worlds of Yggdrasil. And in the new world, it could be the explanation for why the world map of Overlord resembles the Middle East. While IRL, the map was just a quick way to come up with realistic landscapes and location for the web novel, the in-universe explanation for this parallel might be entirely different. Maybe the eight Greek kings on the height of their power used Atlas to redraw the coastlines, or even to sink continents they had no use of in order to recreate the normal human world, but without the destruction and the pollution, of course. And perhaps Atlas is also a counter to Ginnungagap, which is the most effective means to inflict damage to any large area and structures. And it would be nice to see Albedo fight whoever currently owns this world item. Maybe she will go all out and attempt to secure the item. And maybe this is how we will see her final form. And while we're speaking about the unknown, let's talk about the obscure and unknown world items. And I want to start with the Goblin King, who, according to legend, battled dragons with an ash branch. Now, this item could just be a guild weapon or a casting rod commonly used in Goblin King builds, but it could also be a world class item, since it was especially mentioned that the Goblin King fought and defeated dragons with it, and dragons are rather interested in these kinds of rare items. And another strong indicator for why this is indeed a world class item is the fact that it is specifically mentioned to be an ash branch. And Yggdrasil, the world tree, and the name of the game, is also sometimes described as being an ash tree. For example, in German language, it's even sometimes called Yggdrasil die Weltenesche. So therefore, it is a strong candidate for being a world-class item. And since the Goblin King repeatedly battled dragons with it, it is unlikely that it is one of the 20, since those are single use. And in general, the Goblin King and his legacy is extremely interesting to me, because normally goblins are fairly weak even by human standards. And yet a common trash drop item, Horn of the Goblin General, is able to summon forth a, by New World standards, fairly strong and competent goblin troop, and an entire army in the best of cases, if certain criterias are met. At the high population growth which goblins need to sustain their population because everything eats them, with these extremely common horns of the Goblin General, and the knowledge of the Goblin King, who is likely level 100, and armed with a world item, and the knowledge of the 23rd millennia, and the advanced Goblin Kingdom resulting from it, could very well be one of the six great nations at the center of the continent. And if they are able to defend themselves against the Troll Country, the Beastman Nation, and the Minotaur Kingdom, then they must be extremely strong, then they must be primarily led by the Yggdrasil goblins, or by other stronger subspecies of goblins, such as the Hobgoblin, and perhaps supported by ogres, who will have to be fully integrated into society in order to give the goblin army some sort of tank. Or, and this is another part of my theory, maybe they are using the high population growth, or rather their replacement rate, in combination with great discipline and sacrifice, a virtue likely fought by the summoned goblins from Yggdrasil, to defend the kingdom and purchase new territory with gallons of blood per meter. So yeah, basically a greenskin version of the Deathcore of Creek. The best kind of heresy. Anyway, I'm getting slightly off topic, so let's continue with the next unknown world item. Shalltear Bloodfallen also received one, which effects are currently unknown. But however, it is known that this item originally belonged to Aureole Omega before. And therefore I venture to guess that it is not one of the 20, simply because after one use, it would disappear and Shalltear would be susceptible to mind control through downfall of castle and country once again. And as Ainz previously said, world items are best used to counter other world items. So I therefore assume that this world item is a permanent one. And its effect might be related to teleportation, since Aureole is in charge of Nazarick's internal teleportation network, and Shalltear was put in charge of facilitating instant transportation via her gate spell outside of the tomb. And this also means that during the hours of defeat, the Kragoa were up against two floor guardians, each armed with a world-class item. A bad day indeed. And now for the last one, let's switch topics from something very bad to something extremely good. Lord Peroroncino, the most cultured man in the entire guild, was obsessed with his favorite kind of art, especially when it comes to games and visual depictions. And in a similar manner, Ulbert Elaine Oddle was obsessed with a world item that could summon forth an unlimited number of quite powerful demons and devils. His obsession went to the point that he tried to recreate this item by bestowing a statue of Baphomet with gems, and each of these contained the 10-tier spell Armageddon Evil, which would also summon numerous, but by the standard of Yggdrasil players, fairly weak demons, which is likely the reason for why Ulbert considered it to be a failure. His initial prototype of the statue combined three jewels into a single item, and was conveniently discovered during the demonic disturbance in the capital of the Rhaestys Kingdom, and thereafter seized by the Magic Guild. Prior to this discovery, Yaldabaoth aka Demiurge was granted his prototype item so that he wouldn't need to abandon his beloved and even more advanced second prototype of this item, which has 6 jewels. And if this world item can truly summon forth an unlimited number of demons and devils, then it could be a hard counter for one of the 20, and maybe even one of the 20 itself, since summoning and replacing such a vast host is likely game-breaking in the extreme. But I will touch on this theory and the other world item in another video, because for today, this is it. Thank you for watching, have a nice day, over and out.